rocking since 8th grade all the way up until to my 20s. My favorite Hip Hop Pharaohs was Funk Valley, you know, Illmatic stuff, Strange Music, Shady Aftermath, Trap Culture, OG Hip Hop. You know, I wanted to be the first rapper in Chicago that come out doing OG gangster rap, hip hop, Nigeria, but on some Ice Cube, Dub C, Mac 10 mix with some Illmatic, Eminem, D12. You know, the basically MTV Jams, baby. I'm MTV Jams, baby. I always used to turn on Comcast and, you know, like, I watch MTV, you know, MTV Jams. Anything about MTV, though, is my, you know, and music choice, you know. We never truly got on YouTube up until, you know, like rappers like Soulja Boy blew up. You know, you have to be the master sensei when you talking about hell. You don't want to unfollow me worldwide. My favorite rappers in the culture is all OG gangsta rap, hip hop cultures. Illmatic, like Hobson, Dizzy Wright, Eminem, Mac Miller, Yo Wolf, Kasky. You know, rappers in that sort, you know, any rapper who putting it down illmatically and, you know, doing their thing, you know, like MTV apparel and music choice apparel. That's where I'm at, man. And I do stuff like trap culture, like all the trap pharaohs, stuff like that. I do that too, you know. My favorite jewelers in the culture is Avion, Yeliante, Tracy Durant, Johnny Dang, King Johnny, Ice Champ, Frankie Diamonds. Who else? Frankie Diamonds, Johnny Dang, Hutch. Shout out D12, man. Shout out Detroit, man. I'm originally from the Dirty South, you know. I grew in the Dirty South. We moved, you know. I made a killing in the Dirty South off the trap, man. Worldwide. My greatest milestones in hip hop is Def Jam, Fight for Hip Hop, G Unit, Bulletproof, Wu-Tang Clan, Silent Style 2. You know, hip hop video game industry, stuff like that, man. All hip hop video game industry, stuff like that. That's me right there. I knew I was hip hop like from 8th grade all the way up, and as an adult, you know, I'm still hip hop. I'm helping all pharaohs get rich. That's what I want to do, man. I want to help hip hop get rich, make millions of dollars. You know, you have to be the master sensei in the culture. You can't just throw shots at people and go outside and think that, yeah, this gonna be fight. The nigga up the street gonna get over with you. The nigga down the street gonna get over with you. And you most definitely can't enter hip hop just trying to, you know, come in the culture bullying and saying this and that about thirst. Everybody wants to love everybody in hip hop. Who wanna pick a side at the end of the day? You know, back in the day, the beef movies and stuff like that got a pass because you knew all of them was real, real lyrical pharaohs. You know, you wasn't talking to no little dog in the culture to where it's just like, all right, you playing with nations, you playing with what somebody stand on. And even when a rapper would throw, even though I have to be the master sensei, don't get me wrong, even when a rapper, you know, said something about the Bloods or the Crips or who, it was balls, so you didn't care, but you had that much respect, you know. Shout out rappers like The Gang, you know, N.W.A. Wu, and any of those rappers, you know, they was in their region, so they could say something, blah, 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 even though it bypassed, ain't nobody never think about Wu, but, you know, yeah, I reside Dirty South, the lyrical content. I don't want to make fast-paced music that's gonna have you lost in the sauce to where everything around you feel chaotic. You can't think, you can't even get the true feeling of hip hop or Illmatic Mind or, you know, Dirty South or trap culture, OG gangster rap, hip hop. You know, that's where I reside. BS Summer. Shout out Frenchie, Wooda Kid, Waka Flocka, Gucci Man. Shout out, you know, everybody in the culture for putting it down, man. I have always said this as a kid, you know, if you want to enter hip hop, you got to know that we all know about millions and billions of people. You know, you can't get in this, and I have a real, I want to be a safe, sound pharaoh who just pushing entertainment to get to the top and help other pharaohs be rich. Because if not, you're going to be a danger worldwide to millions and billions of people. And on top of that, you know, you're not going to be able to do what you thought you was going to do. You know, because at the end of the day, wherever you touch down, that they know you in your reach. So, you know, and I want to say this, man, like, a lot of times people be making it hard for pharaohs and stuff to love all pharaohs and, you know, to get that chip off their shoulder to where it's just like, I love the culture and ain't no better spiel than the culture. Because it was times in the culture where you really didn't have too much of that. But, you know, if it was that, you know, you tuned in because they dropped Def Jam. So, you know, it's been 15 years since Def Jam dropped, and that's why the culture has been in shambles, you know. And anytime pharaohs beefing out, people were actually taken to the heart. People try to, you know, assassinate, hurt, woo-woo. But if Def Jam was to drop every year and every, you know, every once upon a time, then you automatically know, like, yeah, woo-woo, Def Jam could blend in with what's going on in the culture. So you could be able to say, all right, our pharaohs going to be able to live their whole life with just playing over the video game. Because when we was kids, we knew that if two rappers said something to each other, a Def Jam drop, it counterclocked it. Y'all good now. That was for the culture, you know. So, you know, you got to watch out, you know, for what's popping in today's society to where, you know, rappers is actually dissing the dead, dissing this, dissing that, dissing this, dissing that. You know, you got to be... you got to be a real pharaoh, a real leader, because I will say, you know, the game is way more legendary than a fast-paced rapper. The game has probably dropped classics that didn't make you feel like he was lost in the sauce when he was under the influence. So, you know, you got to get down OG gangster rap, hip-hop, Illmatic,